New COVID pills. Most important things you need to know. Two COVID-19 antiviral pills received a blessing from the US FDA. These may help keep people out of hospitals due to COVID-19. However, there are things that you should know about them, especially the don'ts. Keep watching to learn more. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative, and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. Right now, Paxlovid by Pfizer and Molnupiravir by Merck have received emergency use authorization in the US. Both work by interfering with the coronavirus's ability to replicate and spread in the body. While the pills showed performance, they're not for everyone. Plus, you can take them as prophylaxis to protect yourself from COVID-19. These are treatments exclusive for specific patients. So, don't consider them as substitutes for vaccines. Let's start with Paxlovid. On December 22, the US FDA granted EUA to this antiviral as a treatment for mild to moderate COVID-19. It has two main components, nirmatrelvir and ritonavir. The former is what stops the virus from replicating more copies. The latter slows down the breakdown of the first component, so it would stay in the body at good concentration levels. The current rule is 2 tablets of nirmatrelvir and 1 tablet of ritonavir, taken at the same time twice a day for 5 days. That's 30 tablets. But it shouldn't be taken longer than 5 straight days. Next is molnupiravir, which received EUA on December 23. It is also meant as a treatment for mild to moderate COVID-19. The active component stops the virus from replicating more copies by adding errors in that process. Patients must take 4 200-milligram capsules every 12 hours for 5 days. That's 40 capsules in total. No patient should take this drug longer than 5 straight days. Adults and children can take either pill. However, there are warnings for each drug. The FDA says that molnupiravir may affect bone and cartilage growth, and Paxlovid is not recommended in patients with severe kidney or severe liver impairment. Molnupiravir may also harm the fetus, so not recommended for pregnant individuals. Plus, both drugs may interact with other medications the patient is taking. Have you heard about these oral pills? What are your concerns about them? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.